Hey everyone, welcome back to the blacklotusgo.com video series. I'm still working on all things Arclight Phoenix, and today I'm embracing the full power of 8 drakes, and still using the Drowned Secrets. Basically the idea behind this deck is stuff in all the super powerful Izzet creatures, the Electromancer, drakes, and Arclight Phoenix, and then try to support them with the rest of the deck. So I'm still working on this. I started with 2 maximized velocity, but I found like it's just hard to cram enough shocks and lava coils in there to not get run over by the aggro decks. You really need these copies of Radical Idea, Charter Course, and Opt. So this is kind of the bare minimum you can do to have all those combos. The sideboard is kind of random right now. These are all good cards, well, for the most part, but I'm just going to play some best of ones right now and see how the deck does. Destructive event. I probably have like 30 deck lists with Arclight Phoenix in them in my deck building screen. So this deck is, I mean, this kind of list is really close to what a lot of players used at the Pro Tour. You know, is it Drakes, is it Phoenix, whatever you want to call it. Those decks run more copies of cards like Tormenting Voice. And instead of running Drowned Secrets, which is really good at getting 3 to 4 copies of Arclight Phoenix in play, but it also powers up the Drakes. It lets you kill with them super quickly. So we're going to see if it works consistently. I would like this hand much better on the play, but I'll give it a shot. Doesn't have any removal spells, so we're going to rely on these creatures. So I don't have a card I necessarily want to discard. I guess Radical Idea is fine. But that would be a reason to play Discovery next turn instead of Charter Course. It could be a mirror. Yeah, it looks like what it is. Opponents on the play and with a seemingly better draw than us, so we'll see. I don't want those. I would keep Lava Coil because it's good against the Phoenix and the Drakes, but the opponent does not seem to have Electromancer, which is all I want Shock for. Opponent probably should have played that on their first main phase. On it second time. This one is fine. I'll just get another Drake and play. They can discard to deal with it, but it uses up the whole turn again. So next turn I'll probably Discovery and then Charter Course. If I had Drowned Secrets this game, it would have been great. It would have found more Phoenixes, probably. Like, when I was running the dedicated Drowned Secrets build, it always felt like the best card in the deck. So why not play Izzet Drakes with also the best card in a deck very similar to it? I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. Ooh, they made a mistake by not killing this Drake. I think they're gonna take like 6 or some points of damage next turn, probably. Unless they have a lot of glue right now. Could happen. Well, he's kind of getting us. Alright. That's a little annoying. I don't have time to cast more of those. I don't have access to a discard outlet, so I discard a radical idea. And I think I can use this land. I think next turn I'll play Drowned Secrets. I can save Crackling Drake for like a... Well, I guess I only have one maximize velocity in the deck now, but I have a good chance to find it. Okay, our opponent still just has one Phoenix. That's good. Yeah, I'll just start doing this. Okay, we found that thing. I think that's good, actually. I kind of want to use Phoenix to block right now. I'm not gonna cast that. Let's cast this one. So I know at least one Phoenix went in there. I didn't check if more did, but I think I'll just leave back because this thing's gonna be lethal no matter what. Well, it's only 12 now, but it'll probably be lethal by the time you use it. I'm forcing them to at least interact with this Phoenix, whereas if I just put them to 15, they could just not care about it. Ooh! Okay, I gotta go for lethal next turn. Which is quite likely, I think. I get at least two mills from casting the Drake. And then it gets plus one, I get to discard a card, and cast a radical idea. Well, that's all my mana. I'm pretty happy with that, actually. Let's see. Is it possible? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well, I can cast the Drake first, see what happens. So if I cast Chart of Course, I mill two more, I draw two and discard. It's close. I'm just gonna cast it though. See what happens. I can't get the Phoenix back this turn anyway, so. Okay, I could cast the Opt. Well, I have to cast the Maximize Velocity. I kinda wish I drew 15, 16, 17, I'm one short. If I drew two spells in those, I would have won this turn. But I'm just gonna do this. Let me just make sure I'm not missing something. I don't think so. Well, now I set to an Arclight Phoenix, so that's good. Man, so close. I could have gotten rid of one. So that's the power of Drum Seekers, though. Like, I was way behind this game, and then my opponent tapped out, so I was like, okay. I'll try to leave for you. If I get that shock. How many have I used? One, two... So there's one in the deck somewhere. So a shocker, a phoenix. Next turn they get to go crazy. And just four cards. And next turn they can basically draw a ton of cards. Phoenix. Just one. I'm very likely to hit multiple copies on my turn. I'm gonna be milling at least six. I'm pretty happy with draw seekers in this game. And the mirror match is an important matchup, clearly. It's like one of the best I can standard. Alright, I think I'm gonna win. They can leave back a blocker, but I can probably, well, that'll do it too. Oop. I was gonna mill 6 out of my 20 cards. Well, actually, technically it would be like 9, because you can count the draw steps since I can discard them. So I was likely to hit 1.5 Phoenix. Phoenixes. Alright, that was a sweet win. I like this deck. It's looking good. It's pretty fun as well. It's kind of a combo deck. There's some ops. It's definitely a keep. And short. If I already had red mana, I would probably bottom any land. But since I don't. Alright, aggro matchup most likely. That was dumb of me. I was just on autopilot there for a second. That's fine though, I just cycled it. Getting through the deck a little. If I could take it back, I wouldn't do that, but it's not that big a deal. I would love to have a Enigma Drake right here, but that's fine. I can just get Drake in play. Or Phoenix, I mean. I think it's worth it. Oh. I don't have a discard outlet, though. Do I really want to bottom that? I think I do. So I'd rather hit Moto Bug. Alright, let's dig in. I'm basically trading a shock for a 3-2 Flying Haste, which might not be worth it, might be. But I'm doing it. Our opponent could still be like just like so, but it's a weird mana base for them. It could be like Angels or something like that. I mean, the shock was kind of like Lava Axe. Alright, so we traded shock for shock. I guess that's fine. I'll just play Crackling Drake next turn. Ooh. I kind of want to just shock now, but I think also just Drake and then the following turn shock. And hopefully get back one or two points. Oh, that's tempting too. Because now I have a play. I think I will do that. I might. It's gonna be hard to trigger Phoenix, but I can do it in two turns from now. Drown Seekers will hopefully find like cards like Radical Idea and Maximize Velocity. It's a little scary, but it's not the worst thing ever. Like, I think we'll have like three turns to survive. Yeah, we can probably kill everyone by then. I don't have any beacon bolts in this list, so I can't really deal with it really that well. Might want to put one beacon bolt in the deck. Because I gain access to it so much with drone speakers and all the cantrips. It's just, I don't know what to cut for it. It's such a tight list. I've seen a different number of rank counts anywhere from 18 to 23. Uh-oh. Lightning Strike or something like that? Okay, I think we're in some trouble. This doesn't get first strike, right? It's just trample and vigilance. So maybe I can try to block it with Phoenix or something. Call order. Good cast. Arclight. Let's see. Taking a lot of damage. I don't know. I'm not even sure what I'm hoping for, really. I guess any removal spell is not bad. I hope for that combo kill with the Drake. Well, it's not that vigilance, but. Alright, now at least we have options next turn. We're gonna be on really low life total though. Dead to like a lightning strike or. Yeah, this is the one, I think.
You should be proud to have come so far.
So I have outs. Outs being any Drake, I guess.
Be strong.
Which is not that unlikely. We have at least two draw steps, right? Well, I guess since I don't have Electromancer, the radical idea means I'll be short on mana, so I would have to get Nimble Drake. I could have Shock too. Alright. Well, I'm gonna discard the Phoenix since I'm dead if this stuff doesn't work. This seems to be a spell. Alright. We had a chance. It would have involved, like, ending a cantrip train with a lava coil, blocking with a phoenix. I don't know. Yeah, I'll have to probably throw a beacon bolt in the deck. I mean, it's kind of a catch-all in other matchups, but I'm a little soft to Aurelia. Especially because of the vigilance part of it. I don't know how common that card will be going forward, but it is played. I guess most of the time I'm hoping to just trade with it. This hand looks pretty nice. Unfortunately, two shock lanes, but it's alright. I'll just play Dapter one. Against another point, Mulligans. I'm just gonna kill that. That's my friend of the land. Might be a kind of limpy play, but. So now I can use all my other next turn as well. Oh, Orchard, huh? That's an interesting choice. Alright, so this Crackling Drake will be huge very quickly. Hopefully they don't have, like, grab the Chupacabra, cast down, any of the things that they probably have. Oh, it's like a mono green deck. I guess that makes sense. Let's do like a 3-4. Okay, so this will be a race game, and I'll probably win it. As long as I don't have another steal like this turn, I'm feeling pretty damn good. If they do, I'll have to block it. Okay, so I'll start with, well, I can just draw two, right? Well, no, it makes it bigger. Ooh, I found Phoenix. Can't do it yet, but that's fine. I'm not gonna win next turn. It's just kinda nuts. If I can get the Phoenix, I have two Phoenix back now, so if I can get those back, it's game over. But even now, I can play the shock, that's 12 damage, so I just need to find two more spells. It's pretty easy. Just if I draw any cantrip. Even if I just draw a blue spell, it's a creature. I might mill some stuff. If I don't find lethal, I'll have to consider how to stay alive. Oh, they're just gonna kill.
The wild wasn't meant to be contained.
Now I really do want to find the Lady of Phoenix in play. Not this time. Five, six, seven, eight. This is looking a little scary. So I'm just gonna shock the Vivian Reed. Attack them.
I've seen squirrels.
And then maybe I can finally throw. Or I could hold it back, take five. If I trade, what happens? If they put them at 11, it's not that realistic that I kill them. I think it might be. It might be. Bit two though. If I hold back, I can trade, go to stay at 10. I think I'm gonna trade. It prevents so much damage. Going to 2, I would die to anything like Seeker Squire. Man, flooding out at that point, at that turn, hurts so bad. Like, basically, I feel like anytime I draw a blue cantrip, I win this game. So I don't want to force the next turn to be top deck or lose. Like, if my opponent had, like... Oh, great. Alright. So one of... I didn't know any radical ideas. Well, I didn't really cast any blue spells this game. Alright, hopefully we have two more steps, but could be just one. Looks like two. Okay, good stuff. I didn't know anything. I'll just hold the maximize velocity in hand, because it's an easier way to trigger Phoenix, and it's not like I guarantee clocking him in two hits if I attack. Oh, that's not good. My opponent is giving us the business. If I draw any cantrip, we claw our way out of this. But we only have one more try. Oh, we're dead. Unless this is a radical idea. We're going through half the deck, right? Where the hell are they? Okay, that's the game. Just needed to not hit a pocket of air in the middle there. If there were any radical ideas in the top half of the deck, we would have been fine, I feel like. Even though we drew lands and maximize velocity, like, the radical ideas would have canceled out. I mean, consistency is a bit of an issue with this deck, with the trying to run all the creatures and the enchantment. Your spells are a little low. But that particular game, I think, was just like the lower end of variance. I will continue looking at the deck list, see if I can squeeze in a Beacon Bolt and more cantrips, but it's really hard. I don't know if I can turn the land or, you know, reduce the burn spells. Mulligans. Let's see. Alright, let's hope. Not looking good.
Alright,
Pokemon. Alright, we're in the mix. Yeah, at least get the cast spells this game. And I'm just gonna kill that side on. Oh, that's tempting though. Yeah, I'll do this now. Well, actually, I should have played Discovery. I just want to play two spells next turn. That's fine. They offer the trade. Alright, I don't think I would have taken it. Just need land. That's good. I had a feeling I'd get off it right now. I'll just get him punch you, I guess. Question is, do I want a radical idea away at Drake? I think I do. It just gives me more chance to find a land to do more stuff next turn. Sure is not a logical target. They will have mana up this time though. That's okay. I feel like I can win this race. I'm pretty happy with that. Drake flooded. I'm hoping for a land. That'd be great. Okay. You're gonna have to two turns here. So that's not bad. Do I wanna shock this turn? No, I don't think so. I'm gonna just shock her. Okay. I mean, it seems like I have guaranteed the next turn, so. To find this spell. Well, not necessarily. I can just, like, if they draw the Lord thing, I'm still alive. Oh, I'd be dead if I didn't have the shock, right? It's crazy. Oh no, I could just block. That was surprisingly close. I guess I flipped out. Again. I don't know. There's only 20 lands in the deck, but maybe it's supposed to be 18 or 19. It's not like I really flooded that game. It was just a closer race than I realized it would be. Alright. Back at 500. I put in the full playset of shock because it's just a nightmare to play against mono red or white weenie without those, but there's only three lava coils, but it's so much better against most other decks. And then having extra cantrips would be nice. Man, so many one mountain hands. I feel like I've gotten this hand before too, like Two lands, two ops. I'm just looking for action, I guess. Drawn Secrets or Drakes. Electromancer. Okay. Or I got some on the rapid. I don't think turn one shock your face is ever right. But here we are. I can't afford that. Now I have a decision. I think I'll just play the Drown Secrets. So that next turn I can spend all my mana cantripping if I need to find the land. And then, like, I was considering shocking the Pyromancer because every life point matters. But now that I've got the Drown Secrets in play, I don't really have to do anything else this game. I can just cast instants and sorceries and hope Phoenix wins the game for me. Which is looking like a tall order, but we'll see. So I'm going to opt, hope to hit a land drop. Okay. So we'll have to see if we find a Phoenix. Probably just playing this team that's tapped, though. I do want that. Okay, so I'm just gonna shock. If they have another Wizard's Lightning to play now. Alright, that would be great. We got a chance. It's gonna rely on Enigma Drake getting there pretty quickly. We're hoping they have cards like Runaway Steamkin. Oh my goodness. Alright. Alright, we just gotta hope now. Oh, they're on the burn deck. Oh, we're dead. Okay, I have to opt into a land. Play the Enigma Drake. And hope to win soon. Oh no. I still hit maximize velocity next turn. Okay. Is there anything out here? I want a hand. In the yard. Okay. Whew. Let's see. I can't get a kill next turn, I don't think. Oh, draw your card. Am I going to need to get Phoenix in play? I don't think so. Oh, this stinks. Okay. Well, I have to hope I can kill him next turn, I think. And I still might just be dead right now. I could consider sideboarding Creeping Chill for this matchup specifically. I don't know if it's worth the sideboard slots, but I don't think there's all that many. Like, I don't want to sideboard too heavily in all that many matchups. It's probably not right, but it's just something I like thinking about, because I really like Creeping Chill. But it's only good when the life gain half is good. Alright, that's good. Alright, so this was a poor run with the deck, 2 and 3. But I'm gonna run it back. I'm gonna try again, because I think this was just like, kind of got mana floated against one of our better matchups. Lost to mono red, as expected. Nothing too crazy. So I'm just gonna run it back. Oh yeah. I wanted to check the deck. Let's see, can I put a Beacon Bolt in here? I could trim the land, but I was getting mana screwed too. It's hard to tell. Shock. I don't know. I have 3 Electromancers already. It's so good, but I don't know. I'm just gonna run it back. 5 games is not really a sample size. Like, there's tensions in between playing the powerful payoffs and playing the things that enable the payoffs, right? It's possible I could go down to two copies of Drowned Secrets, but I don't want to. I really like having it on turn two when you have a normal draw. It's the games where you're struggling to hit your third land out, where you have a problem. Okay, I like this hand, I guess. Mana's a little weird, but it's fine. I keep drawing this maximize velocity. I think one is definitely correct over two. Alright. I only have one discard outlet. But it's probably fine actually, just casting it. No, I don't have a land. I'll probably just kill that. It's really more powerful. Yeah, I'm so stupid. That gives me more options next turn. It's possible I'll just win with this 4 toughness card over here. Deck cards like shopping lightning strike and deck like that. Let's see. So, yeah, I'm gonna run up with you. The Arclight this way, because I think I can cast this properly this turn. I kind of don't want to. Right? I'll just get finished back next turn. I don't know, that was kind of a loose turn. I was just kind of clicking on things. Well, this is good for me. Traded my shock for their whole turn. I'm not gonna hit from the spell. Well, I guess that counts. I'm not gonna buff it. I'm just gonna play slow here. Slow in the race. It's a very anemic race. Could consider like Chemist's Insight in this deck, but I don't think so. I think the issues are just the game's free to run over by fast aggro. How does this work? Okay, you can have it. I don't know. Yikes, alright. Well, if I'm not blocking with the Drake, I might as well go in there, right? If I draw any spell, I'm casting Maximize Velocity twice. So I'm not gonna play any more lands than 6. The 6 at least lets me play 3x 2 mana spells. Okay. Well, I can't miss for 2 many more turns. Seems to happen a lot. Like, I'm mulligan a 1 lander because I'm only playing 20 lands, and I flood out when I hit 6 lands. At the crucial point of the game. I mean, that's an inherent problem with a deck with so many cantrips, right? But. Should, East. Attack was a little loose in hindsight, and then no block. Happy with that draw. Gives me a blocker that lets me keep on attacking. I can't quite get Arclight Phoenix back this turn. But I will play the Radical Idea here. Okay. I'll have lethal next turn, right? So I'll just pass this turn. I won't have lethal if he kills a creature, but I feel like that'll help me survive a little, so. Maybe I should have swung. I don't know. Yeah, because then it would still take two burn spells to kill me. I don't know. And they have random creatures in their deck, right? So I'm not as scared of Risk Factor's draw ability as I am against normal mono red. Shoot, fire. Well, I'm okay with that. I just have to trade that, which is sad. I'm not sure what my long-term plan is here. Draw another Drake. Okay, that gets us money back right away. Alright, looks like we have to win quick. We'll find another shot. Do I want to play this Radical Idea? I don't think so. Alright, looked scary for a second there, but got there in the end. Crackling Drake would have worked as well because I had a land drop still available. I'm trying to think about how to mitigate the flooding issue, which seems to be coming up a lot. Beacon Bolt might help that a little bit. So I think one copy is just right for that card. Guess this hand works. I never have the right mana for the one mana spell I draw. So I'll probably discovery looking for action to cast on turn 3. Or I'll just shock. Oh, that's so tempting. I can do that turn 3 though. Just want to get that thing out of the way. No mess around here. Staying at 20 life. So next turn I can Electromancer plus Discovery. And hopefully I don't have that one mana burn spell. Ooh, that's not good. That's not good. Okay. Well. I'm just gonna draw a card. Okay. While we're in this game, it's gonna have to come down to a race again with the maximized velocity. So, just looking to build our mana base and a graveyard and find a drake before we die. If our opponent offered a trade with a war boss, I would for sure take it, because blocking a token would also be a trade, I guess, in that scenario. But I was going to say it would die to chain of weather. Although, if they're running Legion War Boss, like, they can't have that many threes, right? I don't know. Maybe they can. Maybe it's like 4 chain of weather, 2 War Boss or something. I mean, Electromancer never survived against Mono Red. Looks like it will today, though. There's also the Fanatical Pirate thing to consider. Alright, well, now I'll just try the War Boss. Not sure what our opponent is thinking about right now, but well, they missed 2 damage by gaining information on my hand, I guess. Like, some of these mono red opponents, like, they can play as bad as they want, and they'll just lose horribly, because that's how it goes. I could cast a Arclight Phoenix, but that's not gonna do much. Well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yikes. I'm probably just dead. Oh, it's a little late. Don't even have the red mana to get some kind of crazy Drake thing going. I mean, this is not the matchup you're looking for when you pilot Izzet Drakes, and it's very prevalent on Magic Arena, at least in the best of ones, so maybe I should put a little effort in, come over the real sideboard, and play some real matches. Because I'm just running into mono red a little too often for my tastes. I don't think mono red's a bad deck in this format, though. It was kept down by Golgari, which seems to be less oppressive than people originally thought. It wasn't even that good as threat to her. Kind of lost a lot. The mono red beat the crap out of the Wait Weenie deck that was, well, that appeared dominant at the Pro Tour. In reality, it was just a good deck. I'm not really sure what I'm playing to here, but let's go. Okay. I don't know. Sure. Bomb coil. Well, that uses my mana more efficiently, right? Am I alive? They brick, I might be. I'm not sure. 2 blockers, take 3. Yeah, technically I'm alive. I have 3 blockers, cool. How many is this name of Drake? Only 5. Although that's actually kind of close to lethal. I need to find another red somehow. Oh, that's good. No. That's good. Slow mono red opponent is pretty hard to play against. Because the game should be over in 4 minutes, and instead it takes 6 minutes. Ugh, never gonna get those 2 minutes back. Alright, let's try and get past 1 win. I guess that was 2 wins last time. I think just the best of 1 meta is not favorable for this deck, but I'm gonna play it out. We'll see. If I have Opt and Shock, I'll pay the 2 life, but just to play a Shock on turn 1, it's, I don't usually do it. So I'm just looking for land drops, right? And I have the Phoenix to discard, so that's nice. Alright, I get 4 looks at another land, but I'm hoping to drop naturally. Not the case. Oh no. It's happening. Alright, we got there at the last minute. Imagine if I just slammed a Drake that turn. I'd be so much further ahead. But now I'm actually a little bit worried about this. Let's see. So I could, in theory, opt, shock, 2 mana spell, get back Phoenix, so let's do that. Yep. Next turn I can Drake plus removal spell, which seems pretty nice. So they have the combo. I think they will just nothing on Drake. I'm just do this. I'll just race them. I think I'll win. They have to have Tribunal. Some lists do run 4 tribunals, but some lists cheat on it and only run 0 or 2 or something. Usually 2, I guess. So I like to buff cards, so I don't know. Okay, they could still have it. Oh. Yeah, I didn't really see that coming. Guess I could have since I didn't have a 1 drop. Like they're on some Schlesinger style deck. Oh, man, they had it. It's too bad. Okay. Let's see, I'll definitely play this guy. I can present lethal next turn either way, so I'll just block with Phoenix. I don't know if I'm lagging out, because my mana's not tapped. Yeah. Come on. I'm not connected to the internet. Bear with me for a second. I am working on it. All right, should be connected. Hopefully I didn't lose that game yet. okay, so I think that all got recorded, but if not, I have a Crackling Drake on the stack. Might have timed out by now, I'm not sure. Oh, come on, I can hear it. I can hear the rope. I think I roped out. I can't see anything. game was looking good, but I just lost a turn. I guess I can radical idea. I'm not sure why. Oh no, that's so bad. Okay. Well, I don't know, man. I'll be at 9. I need to find a reroll for that thing, right? So. If I had Crackling Drake in play, it would be lethal, I think. I would have also played this Goblin Weaponizer. Player's draw turned out pretty nice. Alright, I just have to change some stuff here. Shock. Is it worth killing a token? I don't think so. I don't have red mana though, so I think it is worth it. Play this thing anyway. Okay. I might live. Probably not, but it's possible. If I chump the Loxodon, go to 1, and they have nothing that matters, I could win next turn. Oh man. I have to trade off the Crackling Drake, so probably no outs. Well, still the out of an Ingram Drake into haste. Yeah. Oh, time walking itself is not a good way to play Magic. You usually lose the game. Phoenix. I don't think there's any world where I win the game if I cast the Phoenix, so I'll just discard it. Alright, good stuff. Oh boy, rough day. It's unclear what would happen this game if I didn't skip an entire turn. I think I would have just killed my opponent. Because they didn't have a second Concrete Tribunal and they would have just died, so it'd be 2-1 instead of 1-2, but we'll see. That one gets an asterisk for sure. There's like just quite not enough time to get back to your game if your internet kicks out and you immediately reload Magic Arena. Like, there was almost no waiting time. I was just waiting for the client to reload. But I still missed. Alright, I'm gonna draw again. I got a decent hand. I haven't had many turn 2 drown secrets. That's what I'm trying to test. So far, I've just been losing with normal Izzy Drakes. I would want to kill Runaway Steam Kin, but that's fine. I don't want to kill that one. I'll just do it. Just mana efficiency. I think this matchup is fine if you have a hand like this one where you can race, but we'll see if it works out. Charge course doesn't play that well if you're trying to draw two. Oh, I like that draw. I'll threaten the double block just to see if they attack. It gives me some information. I don't think I will block if they do attack. I don't think the 2 damage will change anything, really. Alright. I'm just gonna start racing for next turn. Okay, so I'm gonna play this guy. Get a refund right away. Boom. Radical idea or Triforce? I should play Triforce. Because now they can play an instant speed removal and I'll be sad. I mean, they should have played it earlier, but I'm just. It kind of feels like they're thinking. Like, well, that's nice. I'll leave back one Phoenix to block. Well, I can leave back 2, right? I'm winning this game easily. No, I'll just send them all. It's not just one Drake is lethal. They have to like double burn one or something. This game's pretty much over. That's not a good play. What? I didn't expect that. Well, there's a reason they're not there in the 1-2 bracket. Arclight Phoenix is not very good without blue spells. Except in Modern. In Modern, there's a cool Modern deck. Yeah, I mean, we just win. So, let's play some stuff for fun. Sure. Steals my powder. Alright, let's see if we can get past this massive hurdle of 2 wins. It's a huge roadblock. Nobody's ever done it before. We can never get the turn 2 of Drown Seekers on the play, but I'll try it turn 2 on the draw. I only want one copy in this particular deck. In the old builds, I want as many copies as I can possibly find. But, I don't know, this should be good. Let's see, just hope we don't get run over. Finally have the option of turn 1 play. Yeah, I'm killing that out of sight. Not sure what kind of deck they're running, but that seems like a key card for it. Alright, boom. Both of us are playing strange 2-minute spells. Next turn I can just play Enigma Drake. And then turn 4 I can hopefully have my 4th land by then. Yeah, okay. So this is looking pretty damn good. I think I'll play 2nd Drum Seekers and Discovery instead of Crackling Dragon next turn. I don't know. I can go either way. I think playing Crackling Drake guarantees the lethal in 2 turns. Okay, it's just folk. I thought it would be some weird, like, gross style there. I guess it technically is. That almost makes me want to play. I mean, this isn't a bit of damage. let's draw Seeker's Drake. Draw. This is a sweet curve. I mean, it didn't work out this time, but. I mean, it didn't have anything this turn. Oh, Drakes are gone. So next turn I can, like. I need to draw land. First, two tokens. Sure, I guess. I just want to draw land. I can't resist casting to his Drakes. I found all four in the top 19 cards. Alright, next turn I'll get back a. Marco Phoenix and probably the game. I could deal like 30 damage next turn. Or more. I think a regular version of this. I'm not playing this turn. Yeah, I probably would. Oh, should I have just, who cares? Two of them is lethal. Bog. I could have gotten a higher score. I could have played back ideas. Milled. Two more. That was satisfying. That's what you're looking to do when you play this deck. See, I had turn change round seekers, and it led to an easy victory. So let's focus on the games where that happens, because that's what I'm testing right now. We know Izzet Drakes is a good deck in the metagame in general. I've just been, flooding out randomly, losing to Mono Red a lot. Actually, I won against Mono Red once. They were playing Arclight Phoenix, and, probably a suboptimal list in ways that we didn't quite see, but, if you have Enigma Drake, you have a good chance. Try adding white to this deck for definite clarion, but it's so hard. Alright, we have another cool, fun Drowned Seeker's hand. And again, I wish I was on the play, but it's fine. Oh, no! Why are we never on the play on this matchup? It's such a swing to be on the draw versus on the play against Mono White. Well, we're in this game, it's just it's an uphill battle. Okay. I'm gonna drown secrets. Next turn I'm gonna Electromancer plus spell. Or just tap in, I guess. And then turn 4, I can get back hopefully 3 Phoenix. And having the Drown Seeker stone early means if I ever find a Drake, I can almost certainly one-shot them. And that's how I'm gonna win this game is. Okay, I'm gonna use my Phoenix to block. Let's play this. Let's play tap land. They're gonna flip to allegiance, I think. That's a killer. This is gonna be a close one. I'm gonna have to find. If they kill the Electromancer, I'm in pretty rough shape. Because I only have a single 1-mana spell. I would need to find a shock next turn, basically. I hope they're on Malicious Pride, or it's called Conqueror's Pride. Okay. I'm at 9. Post combat, one boss off of Vedanta. That's nice. Alright. Let's do things. So I'm definitely charting a course. So the theory is just to block with Arclight Phoenix until I can assemble a Lethal Drake. Which I think is possible. I'm gonna need to have more than one Phoenix. Preferably 3. Okay, Shock is really nice. Uh, I think I'll spend all my mana this turn. I guess I'll chart a course. Ooh, that's a great draw. This gives me the most chance to hit another Phoenix. They also have to pay 4 life per Adanto save, which isn't free. It seems free for the beginning, but it's not. Sure. And then I'm just doing this now, get out of the way. Okay, so I'm gonna attack with the Electromancer. It's just chip damage, but I'm almost certainly not blocking with it, so. If they have a removal for the Phoenix, we just go to 6, which is fine. We're in no danger of. We can get back to Phoenix every single turn. Hopefully, we can find that maximum velocity. There's only one copy, but we're gonna go through most of our deck pretty soon, so. But we might also just win with that Phoenix thing. Like, they can only do this 2 more times, right? 1 more time? If I find the maximize velocity anywhere in the next 10 cards, I can kill them next turn. That makes me want a lava coil. Alright, so let's just cast cantrips, because I want the Phoenix back. Basically, like, anytime we hit maximize velocity, we know we can win the game. Okay, I'll opt. I hope I don't get punished by having that mana in play. Weirdly, I just want to find lava coil. Okay, that's good, I guess. I could have played a Drake this turn. Well. Okay, well now I have 4 Phoenix. I found a lava coil, that's pretty sweet. Wow, that was unexpected. Sweet ass deck. Pardon my language. Oh, I love Throne Secret so much. I was on the draw against White Radiant and I just crushed it in turn 5? Granted, they were missing lands, but like, that's expected in a 20 land deck with no cantrips. Like, we've seen me and then screwed. Like, usually they're fine with 2 lands, right? Wow, that was such a satisfying win. That was so cool. We started the turn with a 2 mana enchantment and a 2 mana creature in play. And they had 23 life a turn ago. Alright, well, we're doing it. We're putting up a decent result here. I had faith in the deck. I am still trying to consider how to get a copy of Beacon Bolt in the deck. So, Drowned Secrets has been super impressive in these last two games. It can be suspect in this deck when you draw multiples, but that's why I'm happy with 3 copies instead of 4. That being said, it's so good in multiples, it's just, it can be tough against an aggro matchup when you draw 2 copies of Drowned Secret. And no other action. Cool. Turn 2, Drowned Secret's on the play. This is a showcase we're putting up. Put a mulligans. Inconsequent. I'm gonna opt just for land here. That's all we really need to make this draw spectacular. Okay, more of the fishy type matchup, I guess. Oh, I hate seeing that there, but I just need lands. I hate bottoming Arclight Phoenix. Oh, man. Well, now I have a big test. I'm gonna play the Drowned Secrets. It has so much more upside than playing the Radical Idea. If it was a Charter Course or a Drowned Discovery, I would have played that. Probably. But now at least I'm doing something. If I'm just spinning my wheels with cantrips, I'm at least filling my graveyard, right? Okay. Let's give this 2 blocks out of land. Got there. So I'll just kill this thing now. So our opening hand looked sweet, and our top of our deck didn't cooperate that much. So we basically skipped our third turn. Sort of. But we're still in decent shape. It's gonna come down to racing, as it seems every game does. It's a pretty big blocker, I guess. I can probably just leave these as blockers until I set up a one-turn lethal. If they have sleep this game, I feel like I'll play these. Unless I can find a different spot. And that I'm okay with, because it's basically tap with it. And I already thought I'd be down to sleep, so. Yeah, I'm just gonna set up the one-turn lethal. Sure. They only have two cards. And hopefully, since they're on Tempest Claw, they run zero to a few copies of sleep. But there's plenty of ways my foe can push damage in, so I'm a little scared here. That one I'm not worried about this turn. They don't have any good attacks, so that's nice. Oh, okay. It's a tough call if I want to... Well, I'm definitely casting Enigma Drake. So, like, there's no world that I cast Phoenix, right? And there's a good chance that I find spells off my mill or my draw. I don't know. If I find Maximize Velocity, I win. Which is pretty strong. Okay. That's two spells. Nothing off the mill. Ooh, we did it. Is there one Phoenix or more? There's two. That's cool. Do I have lethal? I think I do. Yeah. Do I just go for it? Whatever. I don't know. What I'm looking for. Maybe shock or something. I can just attack with the two Drakes. And flyers. 3, 4, 5. Oh, those are two blocker. I don't know what to take that. We're folk tricks, so that's 10, 13, 16. Alright, well. I don't need to swing, right? I just have lethal next turn. So, sure. Marvel Trickster. Yeah, that's a good one in this deck. Oh no! They top decked that. Oh! Son of a gun. Oh, target creature. Okay, so am I dead? I think I am. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 8. I am not sure if I'm dead or not. No. Cool. Oh, it doesn't tap, huh? Yikes, I didn't know that. Okay. Oh, wow. That was super lucky. Alright, so that was a weird sequence of events there. I thought I was for sure winning, then I thought I was for sure losing, and then I thought I was... Alright, that was weird. Ignoring all, like, our opponent got super lucky to top deck, and then I got lucky to top deck, so they canceled each other out, I guess. I feel like I had way more outs than they did after they top decked. They probably had 1 to 2 outs, I had, like, you know, dozens of sequences that would lead to a win. But I'm just happy I got there. Let's keep going. Strudel. My dad, the inventor of Dr. Strudel, says Drowned Secrets is really good in Izzet Phoenix. Gonna draw some more spells, but sounds pretty solid, I'd say. We don't currently have much to do on turn 3. That's okay. Oh man, more mono red. So annoying. So much of the best of 1Q. Alright, well, second copy's cool, because hopefully I use our turn 2 to burn that one, and now we have a turn 3 play. I'd really like it to be Lightning Strike. Alright. Now I hope they don't have one next creature. Cool. This all seems fine. Just looking to race with Drake somehow. Do I want to trade the dragon? Oh, they're force formation. I'm fine with that though. My plan isn't changed. I actually don't have any spells that get reduced by Electromancer. That's 0-4. Okay. So hopefully I opt into some removal spells here. I'm too much of a limp to block. I'm pretty much all in on this Drake for this game, so. Alright, let's see what we find. If I miss, I might just play the Phoenix, but that seems bad. Yeah, okay. Now I'll opt. And now I'm not all in on this Drake, which is nice. Got two lands out of the way. Ooh. I'll do it. I'm gonna block. I have tons of Drakes now, so I can do the whole one turn lethal thing again. If I can keep my life total a little higher, pretty happy. Let's see, kids are getting a little crazy. Okay. Wow, that was a fantastic draw on my opponent's part. That was pretty cool. The attack with this team can also certainly trade. Okay, I'm happy with this block because it means I can't use it for mana this time. Alright. I can do this first. Well, I'm drawing across the Drake. I'm gonna draw a couple of these spell. If I had a Drown Takers this game, I feel like I would have lethal pretty easily. Around now. But since I had Electromancer, they just killed it. And then I had nothing. Right? Like, if one of these was a Drown Seekers, I would have, like, 3 or 4 Phoenix. These things would be, like, 15 power. I think I'm dead. Experimental Frenzy is nuts. Land here. Wow, they're still gone. Alright, we'll let our opponent put on a show for a second here, but it looks like we're gonna end our run at 5 wins. I'm pretty happy with actually how this deck's playing though, so I'm gonna probably end this video at the end of this run, but I will do a competitive league with the deck once I figure out the sideboarding plans. It's likely I can just adopt the typical Izzet Phoenix cyber plans, but I do have a few more options to consider with the creeping chill kind of effect and extra. I want to try, like, it's definitely not good, but one Nexus of Fate with Drown Secrets is like an alternate win con. My opponent's going crazy. Somehow they didn't find two lands yet. I don't even remember what they started this turn with. Like, if you have a Drown Secrets in play and one Nexus of Fate in your deck, you can just self mill until you hit only the one Nexus of Fate in your deck, and then you can just cast it every turn and mill that for 2 each time. Oh, draw a card, man. So it's like, there's not very many decks that's good against because the opponent's really fast right now, but it's such a sweet way to win, and it's only one sideboard slot. I'm probably gonna try it. Like, I think you'd only want it against, like, Jeskai control or something. Man, look at that. Awesome mono red draw from our opponent. Alright, so finished with 5 wins. A little better than last time. So overall game record, I guess, was 7-6. So not that inspiring, but it's not really a game one. It's not really, you know, most of our losses were to mono red, which is expected, especially in a best of one. So yeah, I'm excited about this idea. I'm gonna keep working on it. Or I'm gonna go build a sweet Vona Butcher of Megan deck. But yeah, thanks for watching. That was Drowned Drakes. Have a good one.